Hey there, folks. I've got another Ubers battle for you today. My opponent is Fiery Guns of Smogon. I found him by using the Smogon's battle request threads. I went on to the one for Ubers and just went through every single one of them, every single person who posted that thread ever saying they wanted an Ubers battle and be like, you want an Ubers battle? And I got like four responses, so it worked out pretty well. So anyway, he leads off with his Deoxys D, I lead off with my Einstein, my Dialga, and I think we're probably both setting up hazards, but I'm just going to go ahead, and I just do go ahead and set up rocks first turn. Usually I predict the taunt and don't, but in this case I just went ahead and did it. Interesting that he's that slow. Usually these guys run a decent amount of speed, but you know, Dialga does have base 90 speed, and I think I'm running full investment, so maybe it makes sense. So anyway, he's got a red card as his item. Okay, fine, whatever. And it's gonna drag me out into my Ditto. And so now I have a choice here, and usually these guys have some form of recovery. Wait, is that true? Doesn't matter. The point is that usually, this is kind of a stupid move to try to attack, but I decided, why don't I set up spikes? And yeah, why the heck not? Let's go ahead and set up spikes. So he goes out into Gengar here, and I think, that could potentially be bad for me. But whatever, let's stay in. I should be able to get off at least two layers of spikes, because I've got one off here, and I should outspeed and be able to get off a second layer. And also, it's Deoxys D, decently bulky, maybe I can even get off a third. So he goes ahead and transforms into Mega Gengar. So now I'm locked in, I'm stuck, I'm staying in no matter what. He outspeeds even after the scarf. I kind of couldn't believe that. So yeah, I do manage to get off two layers of spikes, but I'm not getting off a third, and now my Ditto is gone. That's okay though, he doesn't have anyone, he doesn't have a Xerneas, and he doesn't have an Arceus normal type, so who are the main reasons for using Ditto, in my opinion, because you get all their boosts, and then that your opponent cries. But I don't see anyone who's really doing a lot of boosting, so it's fine to lose Ditto. I'm okay with that. So now I've got two layers of spikes up, one layer of rocks up. Gengar goes for Destiny Bond. This guy is annoying. This guy is really annoying, and I need to figure out a better way of dealing with it, because all that happens, yes, so my attack misses anyway. But it doesn't matter. I can't switch out. I can't really do anything except for lose both of my Pokemon. But you know what, I decide? I'm okay with that sacrifice. Actually, if he'd just gone for Shadow Balls, I think he probably could have taken me out, because Steel no longer resists Shadow Ball, or Ghost-type moves. So yeah, I lost my Dialga to Destiny Bond, but it is what it is, and I'm actually somewhat okay with that. So now my opponent's going to go ahead and send out Kyogre. Let's see if I did the right play. No, I go out into Duroc. Who is my Giratina O, has a decent amount of bulk, so I think it could even take an Ice Beam. And definitely after all those hazards, it can take a Water Spout. So either way, I'm okay, I think. And so I decide to I go for a Shadow Sneak just to get its health a little bit lower. Honestly, going for an Outrage wouldn't have been the worst idea. He does go for the Water Spout. Again, I'm pretty sure I could have survived it without the Shadow Sneak. I guess I was kind of fearing the Ice Beam, but even then I could have probably taken it. It's non-stab, not the best base power in the world. So now out is going to come Deoxys. As if I was smart, I just went for the Outrage to see how smart I was. Drum roll, please. No, I went for the sub. That's even smarter, because I figured he'd want to switch out. So switching out was a fairly obvious thing he'd do there. I go for the Shadow Sneak. At that range, it's a Deoxys D. I mean, I think it's probably going to be able to take that, but it doesn't, I guess. So I really just shouldn't start running damage calcs. But yeah, I do actually manage to take it out. I wasn't expecting that, considering it's a base 40 move, but I do have the Grisius Orb boost, so that might help me kind of a lot. So now that's going to be Mewtwo. I could just keep going for Shadow Sneaks, but you know what, I'm also, so I do actually keep going for Shadow Sneaks. I was thinking, you know, I should just go for Outrage, why not? I mean, he does have, okay, so he has Aegis Slash in the wings. So now Mewtwo's going to go for Ice Beam, and I'm going to lose the sub. And that's really okay, because this is going to be a dead Mewtwo. He can't switch out, because he's got no spinner, no defogger, no nothing like that. So if he brought it back in, it would die. So Mewtwo now is going to die to a Shadow Sneak, and I am ripping through his team with the Giratina. To think, I was thinking about getting rid of this guy. Actually, I'm still thinking about getting rid of this guy. I told you at the last upload that I'm thinking about getting rid of Dialga and Giratina and replacing them with two Pokemon who are quite a bit better, objectively speaking. But I'm not 100% sure that I am going to do that. So he goes for the King's Shield. King's Shield was fairly obvious, and I just go for the Earthquake. But yeah, so now next turn, he's probably going to go for the Shadow Sneak. And I'm not sure if I can survive. I mean, this guy has the attack of a Deoxys normal, I guess? It's what, 150 base power attack? So that's the attacking power of a Rayquaza. But anyway, I actually survived that hit fairly well because, you know, bulky. And I take him out, so that's great. Also, you know, 40 base power move. So now out is going to be Kyogre, and man, I am just wrecking his entire team. Health that low, Shadow Sneak should probably be able to take him out. Not 100%. Well, yeah, I mean, come on. It's been killing everyone else. If it doesn't kill at this range of health with this guy, I will be very surprised. So, Shadow Sneak for an additional KO, and I've got a bona fide Giratina O sweep going, and that makes me happy. That sweep's about to end, though, because here comes Landorus, and I'm not going to want to switch out. I'd rather have the free switch in. So, yeah, let's just lose it. He goes for the Stone Edge, and Dirac, who had 13 HP before that, is going to die right here. So, great job, Giratina. It did really well in this match. I don't know whether I'm going to keep it overall, but it did really well in this match and is making me kind of consider keeping it in general. So now out is going to come Fineman, my Mewtwo. Just going to win this game quite easily by Mega Evolving just for kicks. I didn't need to Mega Evolve. It's a Landorus 4x weak to Ice Beam. I've got the Ice Beam. Just, you know, it would have killed it no matter what. So let's just go ahead and kill it, but let's look cool doing it. So I'm glad I got the Mega Evolve in, if only just to have the Mega Evolve. So that's the game, folks. I hope you all enjoyed it. A nice short one right there. So yeah, comment, rate, subscribe, and challenge.